Welcome back to MMA Inside the Cage, third and final round. Well, if you've watched this program for the last 3 years, you'll know that we love some EFC Africa. EFC Africa is set for November 7th from Grandwest in Cape Town, and this card is stacked. The landscape of fighters, though, has really changed in the last few years.
Oh, it certainly has. We're watching a new breed of talent enveloping EFC, which is the company that defines what African mixed martial arts has become.
Well, it's a great show. Now, let's take a look at the card. Let's check out the fights you're going to see right here on Fight Now TV. First, the main event, the Magic Man Don Madge making his first lightweight title defense, taking on the always exciting Leon Mynhardt. Make that main event pick, partner.
Well, this one has everyone gripping their seats because Mynhardt has been the only fighter to put a dent in the record of the champ Don Madge. He did it last year with that third round TKO over the amazing Muay Thai specialist at EFC 13 in only the second MMA bout of Madge's career. Since then, we've seen the Magic Man evolving his game at a miraculous pace. I spoke to EFC president Kyle Howarth a few weeks back, and he says we haven't even come close to witnessing what this young man is capable of. I think Madge will be focused and hungry to avenge that loss, and I'm picking the champ.
All right, well, I'm going to stick with Madge as well, one of my favorite fighters in the promotion. Yidi Andrutsky, last week's feature fighter, battles tough alum Frazier Opie. Now, this is for the light heavyweight strap. What does your gut tell you, Casey?
Well, it's the Omen versus the Juggernaut, two men that have been on an absolute tear as of late. Of course, Opie, the more experienced fighter, but Drotsky has yet to taste defeat and has been way more active over the last year. I'm going to give it to the new blood and go with Drotsky.
Well, I'm going to go with Opie on this one. I think Drotsky's undefeated, but I think Opie changes it in this fight. Former champ Mikhail Operman battles one of our favorite EFC Africa warriors, Francois Kabulu. I think this one's going to steal fight of the night, but who wins the fight?
Well, this one's interesting because you have two men in different spots of their career. Of course, Operman coming off that disappointing loss to Dino Bogatin. He will be searching to get back on that horse, whereas Kabulu is on the biggest win streak of his career. Four fights, which incidentally kicked off following that loss in 2012 to, you guessed it, Dino Bogatin. I think on paper, most would pick Operman, but I think the stars may be aligned this time for the wild card, so I'm taking Kabulu.
Well, I'm going to do the people on paper, brother, and I'm going to go with Operman. I think he rebounds big here after losing his title. Look for Mikhail to finish Kabulu. Finally, the big boys throw down as Brendan Grunewald faces the Black Panther, Bernardo Makishi.
Well, I say this every time. Bernardo Makishi may have the best look of any fighter on the EFC roster, and he always comes to fight, but I think Grunewald shifts gears amidst the heavy firepower and seals this one up.
I'm going to go with the Black Panther on this one to get back on the right track. Well, I'll tell you what, the event is set. You're going to see all the biggest fights right here on Fight Now TV, December 7th from Cape Town. For more information, check out EFCAfrica.com now to get you in the EFC mode. Let's deliver some action. It's your MMA Inside the Cage main event of the week.
And it is a massive reach advantage for the Pitbull. EFC Africa brings you round number one. Van Heerden in the black shorts. Drotsky in the white and black. Drotsky quite happy on the ground.
Very, very happy on the ground. He had a slip with an inside leg kick. And
both possess great power. Van Heerden catches him.
Swinging wildly does Van Heerden. It didn't look like he really made contact with any of those shots. And again, Drotsky very comfortable. He wants Van Heerden to come down and play his game. Inside leg kick checked by Van Heerden. Again checked. Now Donnie lands a couple of big shots. And now Drotsky sets up for the takedown. Gets Donnie down successfully, tries to move to side control.
Pitbull
tries for the armbar. Might try work it into.
He's popped out, yeah, but that armbar.
And Kimura, yeah, but Donnie is holding on. Looks like he's working for the inverted armbar, as Drotsky.
A few seconds remain.
Now Donnie on top.
Tries to ground and pound.
Also quite easily passes the guard of Drotsky.
All know that boxing background of Van Heerden. He'll look to stand and trade, won't he? He won't be that comfortable on the ground with a guy like Gideon Drotsky.
Leg kick by Drotsky and Donnie counters.
Yeah, Drotsky's head movement.
And there Van Heerden.
Very good.
Stop. Weird time to warn the fighter.
Tried the uppercut.
And then try and set up for that takedown. Big shot landed.
And definitely.
Drotsky now has got a hold of that single. He's going to try and drive through, put Van Heerden on his back. Now he's got the double. Again, Van Heerden grabbing the fence momentarily. Incredible strength by Van Heerden to straighten his arm. Gets
great
out of trouble
strength.
Again momentarily. And he's also passed in the process. And now he takes Drotsky's back now.
Superb work from Van Heerden.
After being in trouble, now he's got the top position, and Drotsky just powers through, gets in top position. It looks like Van Heerden wanted to work a kimura of his own. 10 seconds to go. Gideon Drotsky in the top position in full mount. He's got that one-arm trap. Van Heerden won't be able in range and you start landing. It's so easy for him to just change his level, drop down and shoot for that takedown.
Yeah.
As he does right there. And he puts Van Heerden straight back down on his back. And that's why he's been so tentative so far in this fight.
Once again, Van Heerden escapes.
Very, very bad spot. And Trotsky is just sticking to Van Heerden's back. He is not letting go of this position.
Trotsky dominating proceedings here.
Oh, there it is! Submitted him!
He set up for the key lock and he changed it to the armbar.
Gideon Trotsky!
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Pavan Ramkalawan has called a stop to this contest. 4 minutes and 5 seconds into round number 3, declaring the winner by tap out due to a key lock. The new EFC Africa interim light heavyweight champion, Gideon Juggernaut Trotsky.
Fighters, promoters, fans, get hooked up. Send us your best knockouts and submissions by going to MMAinsideTheCageTV.com and clicking Get On Air.